as I move, I maintain my center, and I've just broken his. So his head's no longer in the center. Now I focus my power. If I focus my power, now I'm wasting my time. I need to break his balance a bit. Now focus my power. And you can do that in many ways. But if it's very obvious, then he turns, okay? So, you tell me if you got me. You got me? Still got me? I got you. Okay. So, the better you become, the more subtle it becomes. And they don't know when their balance is broken. And Kokyuho is the same. Yeah. I break my partner's balance, but I stay strong and down. So if I break my partner's balance and I do this, that's no good. Hmm. Tenshin nage, yeah. Both are balance broken. I break the balance, the mind stays strong. So here, control and down. So only when I break my partner's balance, that's when I focus my power. Only when I break my partner's balance, I focus my power. If I put power in too early, it's no good. In jiu-jitsu, they explain it by saying, create the form and then apply pressure. So, yeah, create the form, then apply pressure. Never do both together. So if I do knee kazo, apply pressure, and do this, no good. Create the form, apply pressure. Ezuke, I do the same. That's no good. There's nothing between there and there, so I relax. Now I make power. Only on impact. So here, relax. There. And how you are Ezuke, that's how you are Ishite. So if you train Ezuke like this, then Ishite, you will be like that as well. So Uke is relaxed here. Then when you make power, a lot of power. Okay? It's the same. Then I apply a technique and relax. Everything set up. Now I'm done. Okay? So think about this. And I think if you ask any Aikido teacher, same principles apply, except for the no touch one that I don't understand. any questions, anyone? Okay, all right, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.